Today's video is sponsored by OneFootball. Get all the latest updates from the Premier League and hundreds of other top fixtures from around the world, as well as the latest scores, videos, fixtures, stats, and more for everything related to football. Link is in the description. So welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to today's video. A little bit different, as in we're back to talking about the Premier League. I wanted to talk about Manchester United today because of yesterday's result. And judging from the title of the video, what did Solskjaer actually do wrong yesterday for the first time? First time we've actually seen, I think, him get a few things wrong coming into this match. Or my opinion, anyway. Could be wrong, could disagree, but we're going to talk about that. Now, before we get into that, let's talk about the results elsewhere. So Arsenal beat Cardiff City, which was a shame, because now we find ourselves 2 points behind the Gunners again. Fulham won 4-2 against Brighton, and I'm pretty sure in that match, Brighton were 1-0 up, 2-0 up. They were 2-0 up, Brighton, after 17 minutes, Glenn Murray scoring both. And then in the second half alone, Fulham scored 4 goals to come back and win 4-2. That's impressive, very impressive, but disappointing for Brighton. Wolves beat West Ham 3-0, that was a comfortable win. Huddersfield lost to Everton. Everton also had a man sent off in that game after 66 minutes, and Huddersfield just couldn't manage to get back into it. The big one, of course, Newcastle taking on Manchester City. City led by 1-0 after less than a minute. I think the quickest goal all season. I don't know the exact time. But second half, Newcastle equalised with Salomon Rondon after 66 minutes. And then 80th minute, Matt Ritchie banged in a penalty and won the matchup with 23% possession, which is, you know, that's typical against Man City. We know they dominate, but that was a fantastic result. And then, of course, we have the Man United Burnley 2-2, which was a little bit crazy as well. And today, we've got Southampton Crystal Palace taking on each other. Bournemouth take on Chelsea. Liverpool Leicester City could be an interesting match. And then Tottenham against Watford. So that's everything else across the board. But let's talk about Manchester United. Let's talk about this matchup. Now, The first thing that I think Ollie got wrong was the lineup. Now, look, I know Man United have some big games to come. I know they do. Let me actually have a look at what matches they have, if we can actually possibly find out. So they've got, okay, so they've got Leicester City coming up, right? Then after that, they've got Fulham. So you've got, you know, two not too bad matches. But after that, they've got PSG, then Chelsea, then Liverpool, Crystal Palace, Southampton, then PSG, then Arsenal, then Man City. So you're talking within the space of, well, Man City game is the 16th of March. You're talking about 6 weeks, 7 weeks. They're going to be playing PSG twice, Chelsea, Arsenal, Man City, and Liverpool. That's a lot of quality teams, and, well, we're really going to see what they're made of. But we saw the lineup, okay? We had a look at the lineup. De Gea in goal, obviously, no-brainer. Ashley Young, Lindelof, Jones, Shaw. It's pretty much the traditional back four that we've been playing. But then it was like Matic, okay, fine. You play him as a DMF, or what I can see here, he's playing as a DMF. They said Man United were playing a 4-1-4-1 formation. And then you've got Rashford on the left. Okay, understandable, because you've got Lukaku up top, but I still think Rashford is more suited to playing up top, because he makes the runs more than Romelu Lukaku. Pogba in the middle, obviously. Started Pereira, and then he started Mata on the right flank. Now, all season, whenever Mata has started on the right, it doesn't matter if it was Solskjaer, which he hasn't had too many games, or Mourinho, he comes inside. He doesn't play as a winger. He is not a winger. He never will be a winger. He doesn't have the pace or the mindset, Juan Mata, to be a winger. Okay, it's as simple as that. He is a central midfielder or an attacking midfielder, or someone plays behind the back, the forward in the hole, and he spreads the play around. You know, he's a tactical technician type of player. As soon as you see him on the right, it was like, okay, well, we're basically now going to get the ball and we're going to switch it to Rashford every single time. Which negates the whole purpose of having Mata on the right. And it says to Burnley, look, play down that flank, because you're going to have some freedom now, because Mata's going to be coming in. Man United are basically going to be playing four at the back, three centre midfielders, actually four centre midfielders, Rashford on the left, no one on the right, and Lukaku up top. And it didn't work. It also didn't work because Pereira had an absolute mare. And I was surprised because I saw him pre-season. And just Pereira didn't play too bad. I thought, you know, he's got potential because he was working. But yesterday, I have no idea what position he was meant to be playing. He was playing at some point with Matic as a DMF. Why are we playing two defensive midfielders against Burnley at home? Makes no sense. Burnley yesterday, by the way, had, let's have a look here, 6 attempts, 4 on target. So 4 on target, 2 goals. 50% finishing ratio isn't bad. Manchester United had 28 attempts. Okay, that's attempts though. Some of them were woeful. 9 on target, it's not the best ratio. 75% possession, 647 passes with an 87% accuracy. We had 11 corners to their 3. And that's it. We didn't really create enough for my liking. Now, Marcus Rashford wasn't at his absolute peak yesterday. Maybe he was tired out. Should have scored, shouldn't he, after less than 10 minutes. He was through on goal. Lukaku actually played him in nicely. I don't know how he missed it. If you saw the replay, it was almost, I mean, he was literally 5 yards out. He decided, for some reason, I'm going to try and smash this with my laces, and it sort of bobbled and it just went wide. And all he had to do was place it. I mean, the ball sat up nicely for him to just adjust his body and place it into the corner. If United score in less than 10 minutes, it's a different kettle of fish. The game changes. But unfortunately, yesterday, it didn't. We gave a goal away, Pereira. I mean, that kind of summed up his match. And now I kind of feel like that may be the last time we see him this season. Well, starting anyway. And then we continue to try and score. I mean, Heaton, yes, made some blinding saves. He always seems to play phenomenally well against Manchester United at Old Trafford. A lot of keepers actually seem to do. I don't know, maybe it's the atmosphere, the big occasion, but they seem to step up their game. United couldn't score. Bang, Burnley go down the other end. One attempt all the second half, pretty much, or the second attempt because they scored the first. And it's 2-0. 2-0. I was getting a little bit annoyed, and I was like, well, that's it then. You know, we're finished. Get a penalty. All right, we've got a penalty. It was a penalty, by the way. Don't say it wasn't. You know, he did literally pull Lingard's arm, you know, shoulder down to the floor. I mean, even he knew it was a penalty. There was no protesting. Pogba stepped up. Fine. He didn't take a decade to take it. You know, he got it going. Probably knew he had to hurry up. And he scored. Bam. 2-1. And then we kept the momentum going, and Lindelof comes up with the goods. 2-2, we couldn't grab another one. So yeah, at the end of the day, fine. A point is better than no points, and we're still undefeated in the last, whatever, 6, 7, 8 games. But Solskjaer, for me there, he got it wrong tactically. I don't think you start Mata as a winger. Just don't do it. There's no need. He is not a winger at this point in time. You either start Pogba and Matic and Mata in the middle, drop Pereira, and then put Alexis Sanchez on the right, or Lingard, or someone. And they can alternate. You know what I'm saying? Rashford maybe can switch wings. But Rashford isn't going to switch wings when Mata isn't playing on the wing. He's playing inside. So I think what Solskjaer is going to learn from this is, number one, Pereira maybe isn't ready for the big occasion. Yeah, I mean, maybe it's a bit harsh, but the fact that I just didn't see any kind of, there's no passion from him there yesterday, was there? He was just sort of going through the motions in midfield. When he got the ball, he was playing it very simple. Like, he was nervous. Like, but I've seen Pereira pre-season, and he was a different player. So, you know, maybe he doesn't start him anymore. Mata, I think, is more of a bench player. Or if you're going to play him, then play him in the middle. But don't waste a player out wide. Man United's biggest threat over the last, you know, 6, 7, 8 games has been down the flanks with pace, and then balls through the middle. When you've got Lingard on one flank, or Sanchez with Rashford, you know, and Martial, he wasn't there yesterday, he wasn't on the bench. You know, Lukaku, I mean, you know, what do you guys think of Lukaku? Is he fit? I mean, if you've got Martial, Rashford, and then Alexis Sanchez or Lingard, I think you go with 3 out of the 4. Lukaku just seems to slow everything down. Even yesterday, like, he gets the ball, And he's just, like I said, he's so slow on it. His touch is horrendous. You never know with Lukaku if his touch is going to be good or if it's going to go into the stands. Or he's going to be smacked out the way. I mean, you just don't know with him. He's so random. So I think, you know, Martial wasn't there. So unfortunately, no, we didn't have the option of playing him because I think he would have played. But I think Solskjaer next time, look, you've got big games coming up. As we say, we've got Leicester next on Sunday, the 3rd of February, away from home. Then you've got Fulham away from home. Then we've got PSG at home, Chelsea away, Liverpool at home. I know there's a lot of players that want to be rested, but I think you have to keep the same. Defense has to kind of be the same. Don't start playing around with it and keep what you've known that's worked. You know, Mata is not a winger player. He's just not. And if you're going to play him, then play him in the middle. But Rashford, for me, I think needs to play more up top. Even yesterday, I think he struggled because he wasn't getting, you know, balls put through. He's a pacey player, Rashford. We've seen that. I mean, the one time he did create that chance in the opening 10 minutes, he went through the middle. That's the player he is. He's got phenomenal pace. His finishing does need to improve, and it has been better as of late. He's still young. He'll learn. I mean, I would take Rashford over Lukaku up top any day of the week. So I think Rashford, put him through the middle, and if you've got the luxury, I mean, today, he could have today, Solskjaer. All right, if this was me, if I'm picking the lineup out of all those players, right? Let's have another look here. All right, De Gea, Young, Lindelof, Jones, sure, that's fine. Matic just ahead of him, that's fine. Pogba in the middle, but I would have put Pogba with Herrera, okay? Herrera, actually, that's another talking point. Where's Herrera? Herrera is a player that will run. He works his socks off. Him and Matic work very well together, almost work in tandem. If they lose possession, they're both working to get it back. They missed that yesterday because Pereira isn't that type of player. So I would have had Matic, Herrera, Pogba in the middle, works fine. Rashford, I would have had up top, and I would have put Jesse Lingard on one flank and put Alexis Sanchez on the other. I think that ultimately would have been a better lineup. Lukaku, start him on the bench. He seems to work better, Lukaku, when he comes off the bench. When other players are tired, when the opposition's a little bit knackered, Lukaku comes on, and then he can use his bit of pace and his finishing ability sometimes to score some goals, and he's done that. So I think yesterday Solskjaer maybe had a little bit of a reality check that not everything is sunshine and roses, and, you know, anything can happen in the Premier League. They're lucky they didn't lose, because that would have been massive points dropped. I mean, really massive. I mean, to score, you know, two goals in the last 4 or 5 minutes shows United's character, though, doesn't it? And the ability they have. But we've seen it. We've seen it before. They've done it with Mourinho. At least they got a point out of it, but it should have been 3 points. They made it look way harder than it would have been. But I think Solskjaer got the lineup wrong yesterday. Tactically could have set it up better. And I think he's got to learn from that. Learn from that in the next couple of matches, especially when we play PSG. PSG are going to be attacking. Now, Neymar apparently is going to be out and absent for those two matches. It's a big bonus. But still, you've got Mbappe coming up against the likes of Luke Shaw. That's worrying. Man United defensively still look poor. I mean, Lindelof's been great, I have to say. The Iceman has been phenomenal. But Bae's not around. Is he around? I don't think he wasn't on the bench. I mean, you basically had Chris Smalling on the bench. Apart from that, that was it. You had Dalot as well. Man United need defenders. That's our biggest problem right now. Defensively, we're a struggle. And, I mean, you look at that back line. Luke Shaw, Jones, Lindelof, Young. It's not enticing. I mean, De Gea, you know, poor guy. You know what I mean? He's got... That's his defensive line in front of him. He's the last line of defense. But, yeah, Lindelof has been quality, though. I'll give him props. He really has stepped up his game. I wish Jones would do the same. And Luke Shaw... Luke Shaw is one of these players, I think sometimes he lacks confidence in his own ability. You know, like, even the simplest passes or the simplest crosses go all over the shop. I think he just needs a little bit more confidence distilled in him to bring the best out of him. Ashley Young, to be fair, has been better this season. I'll give him props as well. His deliveries have been sensational. I mean, Ashley Young can really whip them in. I mean, I'm not talking about floating. I'm talking about whip, bend, a bit of pace, and then a player's there for a simple flick on, and it's in the back of the net. So, yeah, I think we do need another centre-back, without a doubt. But Solskjaer yesterday would have learned a big lesson about Manchester United and which players probably shouldn't start and which should start. I think Herrera's got to start in the middle. And then if you've got the option, you know, Rashford, put him as a centre forward. Rashford will outrun Lukaku a million times out of a million. He'll make every run possible, and he will continue to run Rashford for 90 minutes, where, you know, Lukaku looks like he's been running a marathon after 60. So, yeah, tactically, maybe 4-3-3 next time, Ollie. Mata, no. Start him on the bench. Pereira, no, unfortunately not. Put Rashford up top. Put Sanchez on the wing with Lingard. See how we do. Anyway, that is all for today, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know your thoughts if you did watch yesterday's game, if you are a Manchester United fan. I thought I'd just put that out there today. Something a little bit different. You know, when I see these matches and I watch them and I get annoyed with how they're playing, it kind of makes me want to talk about it. So, here we are. But we'll be back tomorrow with Master League against Chelsea. So, it's going to be a big game. And hopefully Chelsea lose today. But until next time, take care.